G'day guys, hope you're doing well. Just thought I'd give you a bit of an update of where I'm at with the Kubelwagen. So what I've done since my last video is pretty much just add the camo brown colour, and I've given it a bit of a gloss coat, and I've done a couple of dark washes just for a bit of depth. And when I was airbrushing, I've also added a little bit of white to some of the edges, a little bit of a lighter base colour of the yellow, just to some of the highlights of the edges of the vehicle. For the camo brown, I pretty much just use XF58, the NATO brown, and I found that worked pretty well. A couple of little light coats of that, very thin down. I just couldn't get my airbrush to get much finer lines than what I had here. I think I'm using a Badger 155, and I think it's got a 5mm needle, but I just found I really struggled getting much thinner lines than what you see here in the brown. If anyone gives me some advice, I was thinning it down as much as I could, and until it started sort of getting the sort of spider legs where it started getting too thin and spraying out. Dropped the air pressure down to probably about 15 psi, and otherwise I couldn't really seem to get much paint out of it when I was dropping it any lower than that. And yeah, I was really struggling to get any finer lines in this. But in the end, I sort of basically did the brown, and then I actually went back over with the yellow just to actually cut the lines down a little bit smaller, and then just give it a bit of a mist coating again in the yellow, just over the top of it, just to knock the edge off it a bit. And then I've added a little bit of white to the yellow, just the Tamiya FX2 flat white to the yellow, which I'm still using the FX60 dark yellow, and that just to get over some of the edges and just create a little bit more highlighting between the yellow and giving it a bit more of a softer touch. Mainly just spraying from the top, just doing the top of the bonnet, if you like, and a little bit on the top of the doors, and a little bit around the top of the wheel arches. So pretty much right along just the edge here of the arches I did. A little bit on the doors up the top here, and just on the top of the bonnet here. And I did spray down a little bit just on the top of the arches with a little bit more of the yellow mixed with the white. Haven't really starred the inside yet. I did add the decals, and they're looking very white at the moment. Might need to just trim those up a bit with a hobby knife, just get them nice and neat. I was actually pretty happy with the Tamiya decals. I did have other ones that I was going to use, mainly because I was a little bit frustrated with the Tamiya decals that they didn't have an SS number plate, which I was a bit surprised at. So that sort of annoyed me a little bit. So I did have a look around for some others. But then when I did look up the aftermarket ones, a lot of them sort of had were different size number plates, or they were sort of dry transfers without the white, and I didn't have any decal paper at the time, so I decided just to go with these Tamiya ones. I did pick up these decals from Alliance Model Works, mainly for the Speedo, but I found that they were a little bit too small, and when I compared them to the Archer transfers, I thought the Archer ones might be a little bit better, but I don't have them on hand. But I did find this one a little bit too small. I used it anyway, but if I had my time again, I probably would have tried to track down a little bit of a larger one for the Speedo. Haven't really started the inside painting. I've just basically put a bit of whack around the Speedo, and then just put the decal on just to get that out of the way while I've got the gloss coat down on the vehicle. So hopefully it'll show up a little bit there. It's not too bad. It's not fantastic. In actual fact, when you actually don't have the camera zoomed in on it by eye, if you're just staring at it, you're probably not really even going to notice it. It's only when you're basically zooming in with these cameras that you'll notice probably a difference of it. And I obviously haven't really outlined all the black. I've just basically just done a quick coat over some of the black parts, and I've got to do obviously a tidy up and touch up of those, as I haven't added the seats or anything like that. Sorry, the other thing I have done, I've done a little couple of scratches just in the paintwork, and a couple of little nicks. And I did have a couple of paint splatters out of my airbrush, but I'm actually pretty happy with that. I wasn't at the start, but now that I know I'm putting this in a bit of a muddy scene, just the random splatter of some of those paint things out of my airbrush are actually going to help me just to be able to put those as little mud dots everywhere. So rather than having to get my brush out and flick it, they're going to help me a lot. I am still going to get my brush out and flick it, just to do some more mud, because it's going to be a fair bit of mud on this, but it's quite helpful in the top areas, just because I can obviously just paint those, and I don't have to really try and worry about the paintbrush flicking the mud in the right areas. Haven't started on the tyres yet. That's just all overspray from the when I was painting the camo. Some of it doesn't look too bad, actually. Some of it I've got a bit of red on it. Part of me thinks I should just leave it like that and then just put the mud over the top of it. But I'm pretty fussy, so I think I'm going to paint them all black again and then start over weathering them and highlighting them. Anyway, as I've said before, guys, I absolutely love this kit. The more I work on it, the more I like it. I wasn't really feeling too competent in actually doing the little camo skein on this little car because it's so tiny. But as you, the more and more you hold on to it, the more you sort of get used to the scale of it. I know it's not 172 scale, but it's still quite tiny for 135. But yeah, I really enjoyed it, and I'm reasonably happy, probably about 80% happy with my paint job. I would have liked to go on a little bit thinner with the camo brown and probably do a little bit more stripes and stuff like that, but I just found with my airbrush, I actually mucked around with it for about an hour just trying to get the consistency of paint right to get these fine lines. And I'm not sure if it was because my airbrush just isn't good enough to handle those fine lines, because this is pretty much the smallest I could get my airbrush to get down to, even a little bit wider with my airbrush and compressor. My compressor will only really let me get down to to about 15 PSI. Anything other than that, I think my moisture trap sort of doesn't really hold it. Once it gets past about 10, it sort of lets the air out. So yeah, I was having a little bit of trouble with that. Really enjoying building this so far. I've learned a lot of things on it. I'm actually building another one at the same time. So with this one, I'm learning all the sort of ins and outs and all the issues I'm having with it. And then the next one, I should hopefully have a little bit better time building and painting it, just from all the issues that I'm learning from this one. And I'll pretty much highlight most of those problems or issues that I'm having as I go along with this build. Okay, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.